Similarly, if you go to Hinduism, in Hinduism also, if you go back to the Hindu scriptures, it's clearly mentioned in the Upanishad, Chandogya Upanishad, chapter number 6, section number 2, verse number 1, Ekam Evidityam, God is only one without a second. It's mentioned in the Sweta Sitar Upanishad, chapter number 6, verse number 9, Naches Yekasij, Janitana Chadipa, of that God, there are no parents. He has got no superior. He has got no Lord. It's mentioned in Sweta Sitar Upanishad, chapter number 4, verse number 19, as well as Yajurved, chapter number 32, verse number 3, Na Trasya Patima Asti, of that God, there is no Pratima. Pratima in Sanskrit means, it means an image, a photograph, a painting, a picture, a portrait, an idol, a statue, a sculpture. So it says, Na Tasya Patima Asti, of that God, there is no image, there is no painting, there is no portrait, there is no photograph, no sculpture, no idol, no statue. But unfortunately, yet you find that Hindus are doing idol worship. Who's to blame? I'm quoting the Vedas. Vedas is the highest authority amongst all the Hindu scriptures. But yet you find that Hindus do idol worship. Why? Because the scholars of Hinduism, they tell that, see, Brother Zakir, you know, at the lower level, people don't understand, so for concentration, we require the idol. When we reach a higher level of consciousness, then idol is not required. So I tell this Hindu Pandit, we Muslims have already reached the higher level of consciousness. It is the basis of Hinduism, basis of Vedas. But there are some sects in Hinduism, like Arya Samaj, which completely denounce idol worship. So similarly, if you go to Christianity, if you read the Christian scriptures again idol worship. Yet you find that the Catholics, they make an image of God, and they say, Jesus Christ, peace be upon Almighty God. If you go to Judaism, so what we realize that if you go to the Christian scriptures, the Christianity and Islam, the teachings of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, it is similar. But most of the Christians, what they claim that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he claimed divinity. In fact, if you read the Bible, there is not a single unequivocal statement in the complete Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says that I am God, always worship me. If any Christian can point out any unequivocal, any unambiguous statement in the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says that I am God, always worship me, I am ready to accept Christianity today. In fact, if you read the Bible, it's clearly mentioned. It's mentioned in Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 28. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, my Father is greater than I. Gospel of John, chapter number 10, verse number 29. My Father is greater than all. Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 28. I cast out devil with the spirit of God. Gospel of Luke, chapter number 11, verse number 20. I with the finger of God cast out devil. Gospel of John, chapter number 5, verse number 30. I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just. For I seek not my will, but the will of my Father. Anyone who says I seek not my will, the will of Almighty God, is a Muslim. So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he was a Muslim. He never claimed divinity, and is clearly mentioned in the book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22. Ye men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God amongst you by wonders and miracles and signs which God did by him, and you are witness to it. A man approved of God amongst you by wonders and miracles and signs which God did by him, and you are witness to it. So if you read the Bible, even in Judaism and Christianity, they believe in one God who has got no images. It's clearly mentioned in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 5, verse number 7 and 8. It says that thou shall have no other God besides me. Thou shall not make unto thee any image, any graven image of anything, of any likeness in the heaven above, in the earth beneath, in the water beneath the earth. Thou shalt not bow down to them, nor serve them, for I, thy God, thy Lord, is a jealous God. For more details, you can listen to the talk of my son. Tomorrow my son at 3:45 is going to be a detailed talk. This was just highlights on the same topic, concept of God in major world religions. And you'll find out it is the same. We believe in one God who has got no images, and we worship him alone and no one else. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you so much. And you said it for me, because the definition of God as it is tallies exactly with Islam, whatever we have in Sikhism, you know. Can I have another quick one?
Next time.
We'll have the next question from the gents' mic in the middle. That's, we'll call that mic 2. This is mic number 1. That is mic number 2 in the middle. The third mic is called mic number 3, gents' rear section. We have mic number 1 of the ladies' front section right in front of me. And we have one on the side and little on the rear. That's mic number 2 for the ladies' section. Yes, may we have the question on mic number 2, gents' middle. Yes, brother.
Yeah, my name is Arjun J. Rao. I'm 19 years old. Different people are at different levels of spiritual level and refinement and understanding. I think Islam is for people who are already quite advanced at the spiritual understanding. Not everybody can follow its teachings meaningfully. Comparing it to a school, I mean, people are like at first standard, second standard, and at 10th. Islam is like 9th standard curriculum. So am I right that Islam is only for those who are already spiritually advanced?
Brother asked a very good question, that when we compare all the religions, Islam is at a higher level, advanced level. Like in a school, the other religion may be kindergarten, first standard, Islam is 9th and 10th at the higher level. Is he right? I do agree with you. Agree as well as disagree. Agree that yes, Islam is for those who are spiritually high. But that does not mean a person who is not spiritually advanced, he cannot enter Islam. I disagree with that. Why? Because normally for everyone, anyone who enters school, if he enters an English school, the first thing he learns is what? He learns the alphabet of that language. Suppose he is entering school, which is an English medium school, in nursery he will learn A, B, C, D, correct? So, in Islam, even if a person is not spiritually high, when he enters school, the minimum he should follow is Tawheed. The basic A, B, C, D of English language is comparable to Tawheed of any religion. In Tawheed, it is, Tawheed means believing in one God. So what I was describing earlier, when our Sikh brother asked the question about the concept of God, that is the basic. And that basic is present in every religion. But unfortunately, those people who are the religious leaders, they don't want people to follow that. Because if they follow that, who will follow the religious leader? If everyone starts worshipping one God, then all these religious leaders will not be required. There is no intermediary required. In all the other religions, you require an intermediary, a pandit, a priest, a guru. Here it is direct between you and your creator. So all the religions have the same basic message, which is there in Islam. But unfortunately, the religious leaders, they don't want their followers to know this. They want to keep them away, because if they enter the school, finally they will submit their will to God. Submit their will to God means become Muslim. And then these intermediaries, they will lose their job. You know, they'll have to close their shops down. So that's the reason. Otherwise, all the religious scriptures, even though they have been changed, the Almighty God, He got only one religion for all the human beings. But by the passage of time, the scriptures kept on changing. Even after the scriptures have changed, there have been interpolation, there has been fabrication, there has been concoction. Yet, in the remnants of all the religious scriptures, you find the message of Tawheed, of one God. That idol worship is prohibited. You worship him. There may be other contradictory remarks also. But if you search for the truth and you find. So what I say, irrespective, the moment you realize that there's a creator, which I shall discuss tomorrow in detail, then you realize what is the purpose of your life. And then the initial nursery and the kindergarten of every spiritual aspect, every religion is believe in one God, and he alone deserves worship. So anyone who's not even spiritually advanced, the moment he wants to thank his creator, he submits his will, and a person who submits his will, he's called as a Muslim. Hope that answers the question.